Hello everyone, today I'm gonna present you my ebook, Kindergartens Burlesque in Canada. This ebook was born in 2012 in Rome, where I attended several courses in popular fashion and modeling academies, such as Alpa Model, also starring the presence of Miss Italia Gloria Bellicchi, a workout and practice of dance, musicals and acting, burlesque performances at the IALTS, one of the main Italian schools of art, dance and entertainment. In that period, I started my researches on the national libraries on this phenomenon, setting up my studies on the naked art forms and stripping since ancient Greek times up to today, especially putting in evidence the smart and glamorous examples of the Hollywood Golden Age stars. This study is especially focused in Canada, as I found out that in the evolving of the times, this entertainment art form has been developed in the purest and freest of the ways, not stumbling in the tight legal restrictions it has faced in other countries, and has had the opportunity to develop itself in the most heterogeneous of the ways, serving performers of all walks of life and several genres. From classical to punk, from feminine to guys, from eccentric and quirky to simple minimalistic, and their exhibitions are often celebrated during festivals and Hall of Fames annually, but also during the year, and brought to the attention of the vast audience, welcomed and always surprised and curious about what they could expect and watch that time. I believe this is an extraordinary art form that combines sensuality with fantasy and knowledge of specific dancing and acting techniques that doesn't miss to leave room to the personal talent and interpretation. Often, in fact, the single acts are improvised and totally invented upstart from the interaction with the public and customers, and thus the possibility to make little changes to general scripts put in program. As broadly explained in the text, burlesque is not all about stripping, and even if it would be so, it could be partial or minimal and integral part of a more complex scene and context. During all my life, I've been extremely attracted from exploring and studying nudity in all kinds of arts, from portraits to sculpture to photography, and finally on the stage of movies and theaters, and I found that burlesque is the most ironical and funny way to display intimacy without generally putting on ridiculous femininity, even though sometimes it's played as a sort of extreme provocation, such as non-binary e transgender shows. So I've always been interested in these attitudes and performances in private lives and in public, because I believe it's a subtle manner of feminine seduction for the flair the woman put in place in the luring and tantalizing game of flirting to show through their naked skin and the way by she does it, also an intimate characteristic of herself, something more intimate and then resurrecting the other's animal sexual instinct, but they want to demonstrate something deeper, unique, extremely personal, that could mean sick of protection or longing for admiration, or not being afraid to make ostentation of our fragilities to the other's eyes for what we simply are, but that's all we have. What's sensual then? The representation of the deepest essence of reality, beyond the long vest and accessories, beyond the fashion trends and embellishments and often armors the society imposes to us. Much has been discussed, in fact, about verbal and nonverbal languages, like citing Judith Lynn Anna. Everything of us communicates. And often the most stinging forms of approaching and interfacing ourselves and to communicate are non-verbal. Everything tells something of us to others, and in the exhibition, finally, in a way that could no more be hidden. So, burlesque is an entertaining art form parodying societal customs, merging in itself not only breathtaking striptease and pen grinds, but also charleston parties, pin-up photoshoots, music and academy. Also nowadays, it keeps on leaving Odin's mouth agape in the form of a new burlesque, celebrating the chameleonic forms that a woman can take on in their artistic expression and ways of communication, exalting beauty and glam in all the shows, as one for all, the great Canadian burlesque. The new burlesque is the attempt to reinvent and actualize these shows to contemporary days, detaching from the old glory of the post-war exhibitions that held to the scandal in the 20s at the time of the Ziegfeld Follies. This theatrical phenomenon, displayed as comic and theatrical jigs, mixing dances, musicals, and pantomimes, often mocks traditional social habits and customs, reinventing all the pieces in a new original manner, craving for the preciousness, exclusivity, grandeur, and allure of Hollywood Golden Age stars and retro cultural futures, departing from that experience to actualize this kind of performances to our contemporary days. The differences with the past times are huge, mainly for the upcoming of capitalism, the proclamation of the shared values of peace and democracy and fundamental freedoms. While previously burlesque was almost scandalistic and dealt with many troubles because of the protection of what was intended as a public decency and even obscenity, and it was not unanimously welcomed by the general public opinion, today it's been affirming a new version of this form of art that is originally and personally interpreted to make it available for a new audience, sometimes stretching to the exaggeration and eccentric plays, careless of false taboos, Christian assumptions, social prejudices, sometimes ridiculous legal restrictions, going even beyond the disequality of gender in an era in which the notion of transgression is outdated and the greatest scandal is to be homologated and traditional. In the American culture, emphasizing the role of woman that exhibits self transcendently from time and space, dancing and acting in an illusionistic dimension of eternal present where art is art, the motto is "Whatever you're gonna be here, you gotta be in a big way." In the Garters, Burlesque in Canada doesn't intend to be a complete handbook about this topic, but rather a sneak peek on the most eclectic and astonishing aspects of Canadian burlesque scenery in their diverse collections of styles, techniques, and interpretations, highlighting the importance of the main old starlets other than the new ones, the festivals, the photographic studios, vintage magazines, songs, movies, and fashion and simple designers such as Vargas. Among the wide gamut of artists, I've mentioned Bettina May, vegan makeup artist, hair fashion stylist, and pin-up model that performs totally personalized, created shows. The spiritualist Little Wu, pioneer of burlesque yoga e fusion belly dance, a chameleonic Sosie Colaora, Miss Cream best burlesque costume in Toronto Burlesque that brought burlesque on the road to the masses, that studied the classical ballet and modern jazz, Fiona Flontit, known for her innovative theatrical reviews and tailored costumes, the teacher and cabaret performer Coco Framboise with a French fashion touch of style, the romantic and classic Scarlett James, Tania Cheeks the Rebel, and the group The Skinna Hot Sight, starring also homosexual performers. Among the fashion designers, I mentioned inside the House of Etiquette, cinched tight corset, Starkers corsetry, Wallace Playford, Brucalviano, and so on. In this book is offered an artistical, psychological, and briefly historical excursus other than a juridical panorama about the main aspect of the legislation and jurisprudence concerning public decency, obscenity, The Community Standard of Tolerance e The Arm Best Test di Giacomo Case, la Bay Case. This art form, in fact, seems indisputably belonging to the field of freedom of expression, as remarked also in the USA, where has been several times made appeal to the First Amendment, protected as a fundamental human right by the Charter of Rights and Freedoms of 1992, and specifically in this case, women rights. In this scenario, I highlighted how the Canadian experience has been characterized differently from other countries, from a high degree of tolerance, adaptability and resilience, and how much it has been welcomed and agreed by the general public as an amazing form of divertissement. Its title, Kindergarten Garters, is just a pun, aiming to explain burlesque as a sexy kindergarten for male female audience since as kids, left tantalized not only by the sophisticated allure, fascination and variety mixing of art, dance, music and recitals, but also by the personal fantasy and irony of each of their performers. This book has been linguistically revised and elaborated on the English lexicon, trying to be also this an art expression that could be close to the treated topic other than updated in the contents in 2021 in the Barnes & Noble edition. I hope you'll enjoy this book that is available on multiple platforms, among which also Amazon and Kobo. Thank you.